So now let's look at our last macronutrient, fats. Do you remember what the acceptable macronutrient distribution range for fat is? Think hard. 20 to 35%. This one's very similar to protein. It's just a tighter range because how many kcals per gram are there in fat? I've been teaching you for carbohydrate and protein, it's 4. And guess what? It's 9 for fat if you didn't already know that. So when we look at this, we're going to take our same person at 2,150 kcals and we're going to multiply it by the range at 20%. What do you get? So get your calculators out and let's do the math. I come up with 430 kcals. Now, when I do that to find out the upper end of the range at 35%, what do you get? So when you do your math, hopefully you get 753 kcals. So now we know this person needs anywhere from 430 to 753 kcals to give her 20 to 35%. But again, most people don't look at the calories, they look at the grams. So if we're going to put this in a gram form, what do we have to do? We have to take the kcals at 430 and we need to divide it by what? How many kcals per gram in this one? 9. So when we do the math on this one, what you should get is 47.77 grams of fat. And when we look at the higher number at 753 kcals, again, same constant, 9 kcals per gram, that doesn't change. What do you get on this one? You get 83.6 grams of fat. So if I was going to be talking to a client, I would let them know that the acceptable macronutrient distribution range at 20 to 35% would yield about 48 to 84 grams of fat per day. So think about this. When you start to read labels, if you need 2,150 calories, that it's only going to allow my body 48 to 84 grams of fat. So next up, we'll be talking about calculations for your body mass index.